And now is a surprise performance.
after the favorite performer, you should know who the mysterious singer now. Is it the one and only Professor Ben Gore? Ladies and gentlemen, please give him another round of applause. Thank you, Ben. Now, Maggie, please join Ben to have the next prize drawing. The number is 835535.
Normally, Chinese New Year, when we are young, the parents always give away the hongbao. It depends on how good you are the whole year. If you are bad, you just get a little bit. If you are good, you always get a big hongbao. So, but today, the hongbao is the same, but just for the Chinese tradition. The parents probably can tell the history of the hongbao to their children. So everybody line up and say 恭喜发财, and then Professor Guo and Maggie will give you the hongbao. Thank you.
真漂亮，谢谢。我今天穿的是旗袍。说到旗袍，跟我们下面一个节目还有点关系。
我相信在场很多人看过旗袍，甚至穿过旗袍，他们可能不大了解旗袍的来历，不如给下头介绍一下吧。好啊好啊。旗袍是传统的中国服装，剪裁得体的旗袍能良好体现东方女性修长优雅的体态，所以备受中国女性的青睐。Chanzang
is a female dress with distinctive Chinese features and enjoys a growing popularity in international high fashion.
旗袍的英文名是广东话"长衫"的音译。 而在中国其他省份，旗袍的本意是旗人的服装。这个名字背后有一个独特的历史背景。The
name Chanzang, meaning simply long dress, enter English vocabulary from Cantonese in other parts of the country, including Beijing. However, it's known as 旗袍, which has a history behind it.
旗袍在中国的历史可以追溯到满洲人入关、清朝统治开始。 满洲人建立了八旗制度，并自称为旗人。满洲妇女习惯穿的裙装，于是也被称为旗袍。When
the early Manchu rulers came to China proper, they organized Manchu people into banners and called them banner people, which then became the loosely the name of all Manchus. The Manchu women normally wore a one-piece dress, which likewise came to be called banner dress.
辛亥革命之后，旗袍不仅没有因政治变革而消亡，反而发扬光大，并被日益改进，成为中国女性的传统民族服装。Although
the 1911 revolution had toppled the rule of the Manchu dynasty, the female dress survived the political change and with later improvements has become the traditional dress for Chinese women.
旗袍通常都有紧束的高领，袖子可长可短或者无袖，都取决于个人品味以及季节的更替。Its
neck is high, collar close, and its sleeves may be either short, medium, or long, a full length, depending on season and taste.
旗袍的扣子开在身体右侧，配合宽松的胸部设计、贴身的腰部设计以及身侧的开叉。
The dress is bottom on the right side with a loose chest, a fitting waist, and slips up from the sides.
还可以根据不同场合的需要选择不同的长度以及面料。所有这些设计都旨在烘托出东方女性婀娜的曲线。Different
materials and wearing length to match the need of casual or proper occasions, all of which combine to set up the beauty of the female shape.
好，下面就请大家欣赏精彩的旗袍秀。 表演者：揣淑音、董薇、卞琴、张岩、李璐、黄梅宽、王太阿、雷欣荣、唐旭黎、张燕、吴玉婷、惠康、秦静。Please
enjoy the show.
像一样的颜色，它有丁香一样的芬芳，花香我一样撑着油纸伞，它盼望在雨下。 Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, Mrs. Chu, Mrs. Liu, Mrs. Wang for generously providing beautiful dresses.
看完了刚才。 旗袍秀，我知道今天在场的来宾中也有很多太太穿着美丽的旗袍，欢迎上场，也跟我们做一下真人秀。I've
noticed that a lot of ladies, beautiful ladies, are dressed in 旗袍 as well. Why don't you guys come up on a stage and take a walk?
Yeah, come on.
It's a once a year, once a lifetime. I noticed that Mrs. Shanbag. Where's Mrs. Shanbag? Come on up. Oh, look at these girls. How beautiful they are.
What's your name?
My name is Brittany.
How old are you?
10.
Do you like your dress?
Yes.
Hi, cute little girl. Would you like to introduce yourself to the audience?
Hello, my name is Rihanna. I like my dress. Happy New Year.
Hey. What's your name?
My name is Anna.
How old are you?
I am 8.
You must love dress, right? You're beautiful. Thank you so much.
There was a special request from Professor Schomburg because he wanted to show. This is the new version of the latest fresh off the boat from China version of the qipao. My version is the Hong Kong, the hostess qipao. Okay. Yeah. And because of, as you can see, the models are all of different age. I believe I'm probably the oldest. Okay.
I'm second oldest.
Okay. I believe Morris, Mei Chen Morris, is also in a beautiful qipao. Please stand up and let us take a look too. Okay. Anybody else in a beautiful qipao? Okay. Last call then. Okay.
Thank you so much.
好，下面一个节目是民族舞《女儿河》。Next
performance is Chinese folk dance, Girls by the River.
女儿河的编舞曾获中国桃李杯一等奖。And
the performers are
丁文、刘莹、秦旭华、沈世慧、谢轩、赵慧娟、杨林，并且在这里感谢胡雪涛帮助编排。下面请欣赏舞蹈《女儿河》。Please
enjoy the show.
Thank you.
a modern choreography all the way back 500 years. We are the next performance will be a dance choreographed by Chong Hui Fei. This is a really special treat because we are very lucky to have her in our community because she is a national cultural dance award from Taiwan. Many years ago, she was a first prize winner. Okay, and she choreographed this particular dance to a tune from the Peony Pavilion, Mu Dan Ting. And this is an opera, a country opera, which is written in 1498 by Tan Jian Su. And when this, I'm sure there was a performance, I believe, 2 years ago, right in our Follinger Auditorium. And there was a opera performance. And we like it so much. So I asked Miss Fei to please choreograph this particular one for us. Okay. And please enjoy yourself.
Yee-yee-yee-yee-yee.
I forgot to say something. Would Miss Faye please come up to the stage with me again? Because this is really a treat. It's very special. Because I'm sure some of you have heard Chinese opera before, and probably Beijing opera. Okay, the music is different. The kunji is marked by the fact that there is a lot more movement and it's more song-like, and the traditional instruments that used there, as you can hear, is rather soft. And there's and of course, Miss Faye has done a wonderful rendering of the how traditional dance movements are like. I would like her to say something and introduce us to some of the typical traditional Chinese dance movement. Can you please come up and just show us what are the typical hand movements? Okay. Like when she does the fan. Okay. Okay. That's okay. I'm sorry. When you go, the hands go around hands. Okay. Oh, and the other thing is that, as you can see, just now the folk dance, it was a lot of large movement where they, you know, sway from side to side with a rather quick movement. But in kunji, it's always very soft, very slow. Okay, and every movement is rounded, as you can see. Even though the fan that she is using is rather heavy, but because when she holds it, the two fingers kind of like stick out like this, so it looks as though that the fan is floating. It seems as though it's just wave, maybe, you know, really featherweight, but actually that same cup weighs about a pound at least. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Then the other thing is that about the kunqi, actually, we have actually speeded it up in order for her to be able to dance to it. When in the actual opera, they sing it slower, and of course then you can enjoy the beauty of the performer's voice. Okay, it's rather expressive. Seth, thank you very much. Okay, let me say. Yes, we forgot, I need to introduce next year's chairman of the New Year committee. Would Mr. Humphrey Yao come up, and Ms. Sharon Xu, yes, can they please come up? This would be 2005 organizers.
Hello everyone, it's a pleasure for us to be the organizer for the next year's event, and it's going to be a very difficult job for us because today's event is such a wonderful event, it's really hard to beat. But the most important thing is we would like to see you all next year to be here again to celebrate the Chinese New Year and the great tradition. And we will try our best to make the event better than this year, but it's going to be a tough job. Thank you everyone, enjoy the night.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Lolita, for putting me on the spot last night. Anyway, wow. So many good performances and shows, and we'll try our best, Mr. Yao and me, we'll do our best to put same kind of show for next year. Hopefully you have a very nice monkey year. Thank you.
Right now, I would like to invite Mr. Tom Chen and Selena Chen to come up for the next drawing. It'll be our fifth drawing. System technologies. So he is our local big boss.
835-821. Introduce a mysterious singer or backup dancer. This time, I'm going to introduce a mysterious backup dancer. Here again, the one and only Professor Ben Guo and the Dancing Rosé. Four beautiful ladies. They are Sherry Chen, June Shea, Cassie Ito, and Mason Morris. The song they're going to sing is Besame Mucho. Enjoy it.
Besame mucho, vamos a
dancing. But we're going to have a dance demonstration by David Lin of Regency Ballroom. So with David and his partner, get ready. And I also like to tell you that the South Lounge is open now. There will be a demonstration with calligraphy, ancient divination, and various aspects of Chinese custom and beliefs. Please, you can now put in your answers to the challenge poem. I believe that there is, we actually have prepared something that we hope that people will be able to write a few lines of haiku, limerick maybe, or even tangshi, or something. There should be a piece of paper going around to each table, and go ahead, because the Chinese people are quite poetic, and we want to see what we can get from tonight. The only requirement is that you do it tonight, and we will collect it, and then we will post it on the website after the Chinese New Year. So, all right, is David Lin ready? Okay.
All right, great. Good evening, everybody. Wow, we see a lot of beautiful of ladies demonstration tonight. Are you ready to see some Chinese guys dance? Anyway, after all, our job is to make our ladies look good. So I'd like to invite on the floor YK and Irene, and Herb and Kathy, and they will be dancing on the floor with us. And I also like to have Liz Middles come onto the floor as well. And we'll do a couple of numbers for you, and sit back and enjoy.
Where those
those who want to dance can go ahead. We're going to start the music for dancing now. And actually upstairs in the ballroom, the students, as you can see, I think they have emptied the ballroom already, because they're upstairs, emptied the Illini room, because they're upstairs in the ballroom dancing away, and they're going to have a karaoke competition. So if any one of you feel that you want to get a prize and are up to it, you're invited to go to the ballroom and check it out. And for those of you who want to check out more of the Chinese cultural stuff, please, you can go, you're free to go to the South Lounge.